The court will take a short recess before passing sentence.
Mr. Bryan, I'd like to see you in chambers.
I'll be back in a minute. Don't worry about a thing.
Jeff, nice to see you. I haven't seen you at the club lately. Been busy down at the plant?
That's right, Chuck. But our busy season's just about over. How have you been?
Just fine, Jeff. Pull up a chair.
What's going to happen to Scott this time?
Instead of the dog, then I would be. Just took a long time getting here on the bus.
You lost your life in the car. How long?
6 months. On probation. And if I get caught driving again, then it's a slammer.
Well, don't drive, or don't get caught. Whatever, you could ruin her whole summer. What else happened?
Well, he took me out to the club for lunch. Well, I think he's beginning to feel like he's neglecting his son. Or maybe Judge Newman said something to him to make him realize that, well, what he's done to himself, you know, since Mom died. Anyway, he wants to spend more time with me, get involved in some kind of meaningful project, that sort of thing.
It's nice that he feels that way about you, Scott.
Yeah. What he really wants to do is start preparing me to take over the business.
What's wrong with that? I wouldn't mind being in love with the owner of the biggest company in the city.
Debbie, I'm not ready for that. I might never be ready for that. I would become just like him if I took over that company.
That's not fair, Scott. Your dad really cares about you. It doesn't have to be the business. He'll be interested in whatever you're interested in.
Yeah. Well, find out tonight.
What the hell is a drag racer? I mean, I was talking about your coming into the business, beginning a career. Now's the time to start thinking about that, Scott. Why not study law?
Come on, Dad. All I want to do is drag race.
Scott, you've got to be practical. Think of the future.
I don't believe in the future. Look what happened to Mom's future.
I understand your feelings, Scott. And maybe you're being more honest with yourself than I am. But I'm only trying to do what's best for you.
Oh, yeah, I know you are. But you want me to do what I want to do, what you want me to do.
Drag racing, huh? Whatever the hell that is. You want to go drag racing? Okay, we'll go drag racing.
You mean that?
I mean to win.
Buddy cars and top fuel dragsters on tap today here at Orange County International Raceway. Gary Tenchum, the teacher's pet. That's the school teacher driving his Chevy Monza Buddy car. Some of the greatest names in drag racing on tap here at OCIR. Raymond Beadle, the famed Blue Max. Warren and Comer, the Ridge Route Terrors out of Bakersfield, California. Lanky James Warren, the wheel of that fine top fuel dragster. Pisano Mazzavara, Jake Johnson, doing the driving of that Chevy Monza running car. The greatest racing in Southern California's greatest track here at Orange County International Raceway.
Look at that burnout! To heat up the tires so they get better traction. They pour water under the tires to start them slipping so they'll get a good grip on the track. Guiding the car back to where he burnt rubber so he can get the best traction for a start.
Why is the starter pointing to the lights?
He wants them to enter the beams. The first light is the pre-stage. The second light is the staging light. When both cars are staged, the starter lights the tree. There's one yellow light and then the green.
What happens if they leave too soon?
They get a red light and automatically lose.
If you think this is something, we should really see into it. It's unbelievable.
When is it?
Next week.
And from the engine comes the brand new Blue Max.
Why don't we fly down and take a look?
The U.S. national champions,
yeah.
The national record holders until they make that drive out of Ontario, which will.
Ray Beadle continues through with a fine 6.89 seconds. Here's Leon Fitzgerald's throwback to the Stone Age. The Pure Hill car, Leon Fitzgerald, powered by a supercharged nitro-burning Chevrolet. Now to call the action, here's Richard Schroeder.
Thank you, Dave McClellan, and ladies and gentlemen, you're in for a thrill. Down there, that's the flying kite cyclist Bob Carril. Light up on the guardrail, we're going to have represented over a million horsepower when we light all the funny cars. Down at the end of the quarter mile through the center, you'll see Bob Carril coming down in his flying kite cycle. And here he goes, ladies and gentlemen. All eyes to the other end of the quarter mile. The torches are lit. Here comes Bob Carril with the flying kite cycle, makes his run toward the jump. So we can see if Bob Carril is all right. Please stay back, ladies and gentlemen. We want to know if Bob is okay. We can get our crews in here immediately. And we get all the funny cars to clear the track. Now back into funny car action. And ladies and gentlemen, word from the hospital, Bob Carril is A-OK.
Some of these manufacturers product. It's one of those people, Acto. Why don't you give your ignition system the 8,500 RPM capability of competition-proofed Axel ignition? Premium quality Axel points, condensers, coils, rotors, and distributor caps provide the ultimate in ignition performance and durability. Trust Axel to deliver maximum ignition performance in your car, too. Your attention in the pits, please. Racers, the staging lanes are open. We'll start qualifying here in just about 35 minutes. There's quite a number of days in qualifying. And don't miss a single chance to make a run down this quarter-mile here at Indianapolis Raceway Park. The U.S. Nationals, the oldest national championship drag racing event in the United States, and the world's largest auto racing event with over 1,100 entries. The U.S. Nationals, Indianapolis Raceway Park, and quite a crowd anticipated.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Irwindale Raceway, the Grand Prix of Drag Race Racing. We're set to go with the very first pair of top fuel dragsters attempting to qualify in the 16-car field. The very first pair of thundering top fuelers on the track now, and like having completed their burnout, and now being pushed back to the starting line.
The engine?
I don't know. It looked like the engine coming out all over the place.
Everyone stay out of the area of lanes.
This happens very often.
It happens sometimes. It's going to happen. It's bound to happen sometimes.
We're waiting for some word from the other end.
Scott, you want to drive one of those?
Yeah.
No chance.
Look, Dad, the chance of that happening is 1 in 1,000.
Well, that's one chance I don't want to take.
Oh, come on.
No. Don't they have a car that won't explode?
Yeah, they do. They're pro-com cars, but they run on alcohol, not nitro. Yep.
I'm Jeff Bryan. This is my son, Scott.
Jeff?
How you doing?
Scott, how are you? What can I do for you?
Well, Scott and I have been checking around for a man to build us a dragster, and your name seems to head everyone's list.
Well, that always sounds good. What did you have in mind?
I want the best alcohol-burning pro-comp dragster that can be built.
Do you plan on racing for a hobby?
I want a winning car, Daryl. Something we can take to the Nationals. You see, I never get into anything with the intention of becoming a loser.
Well, I think we can help you out.
All right, what are we talking about money-wise here for the complete package? Engine, paint, spare parts, right on down to the tools.
In round figures, about $30,000.
How long would it take to put the package together?
I think we can get one together in about 6 weeks.
All right, let's get to it.
I think you ought to play it cool with this guy. He writes the checks.
Well, I tell you, I plan to. Good numbers on checks. The only thing that's going to take me away from driving.
I think it can do us a lot of good. Here they come now. John, you remember the
Bryans.
Hi, John. Yeah, we're out at the track. How are you doing?
It
is fine.
Hi, kid.
Hey, John.
Daryl? Yeah, Daryl's been telling me about your work. I sound interested.
I'm glad.
Well, I pay top dollar, John. I expect top performance. Daryl knows that.
For top dollar, you're going to get top performance. Because top dollar is the only thing that's going to take me away from driving.
Well, as long as we understand each other.
Okay. You ready, kid?
Yeah, sure, let's go.
Well, she's got the best of everything.
Man, this car is so far out. Darryl, you really did a number on this car. If this car runs as good as she looks, we are going to turn some pinching times.
Darryl, you did a great job.
Thank you, Jeff.
You got a great car, Mr. Bryan. The next stage is going to be up to me and Scott.
And now, down the fire room, ladies and gentlemen, the brand new car and driver combination. This is the all-new radiation blown alcohol dragster. The new driver is Scott Bryan. Scott, now, of course, his main purpose on this run is to make the third and final pass that he needs to obtain a competition license to drive this type of machine. It's a brand new machine built by Bishop and Buell Engineering of Arcadia, California, and it's a top-notch effort. Scott Bryan, the brand new driver, positions himself in the bleach box, the burnout area. Stand by. He is awaiting at this moment the liquid traction compound to go down as it now does in front of the rear tires. Moments away from the burnout for the rookie driver, Scott Bryan. Signal by the crew member, roll forward. The burnout. So as Scott Bryan is being pushed back to the starting line, assisted, of course, by his crew members, if we may, to explain the situation here. The blown alcohol dragster record, the existing national record, is 6.79. That's 6.79 seconds. Now, the new driver, Scott Bryan, must run within 10% of that record. So Scott Bryan is just about set to go. He needs a 10% run within the national record, as we said earlier. And a 10% run at that, of course, would be well accepted. But better yet, I think Scott would like a good 6-second pass. He's made about 3 or 4 runs in this car, and he's been in the low 7-second range. And he just needs one pass within 10% of the national record for his NHRA competition license. Here we go. He's just about set to go. Scott Bryan lined up the brand new radiation blown alcohol dragster. Stops the timers. Oh, boy, we've got a 6.99, 6.99 seconds. That does it. The third and final pass. Scott Bryan has his license at 189 miles per hour, and we have a new driver on our hands.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Irwindale Raceway.
amount of power between these cars. Approximately 1,500 horsepower he's running on methanol fuel. Scott Bryan, what's he thinking about? Wow. First time he's going to be running against somebody. The veteran Johnson Day is back there lining up. Scott Bryan is thinking. On the far side, Justin Kramer. Roy Kramer, he's ready. Scott Bryan gets past him. Johnson Day doesn't feel he does another one. Trying to get tired of doing it. This is the way he was taught to do it. Raise your hand, ladies and gentlemen. Moving forward to the staging phase. Johnson Day leads into the last bit of instructions. Boy, on this young man's mind, there's a lot of ways. First time, he qualified well with the program, but he's going against the veteran on the far side. Roy Kramer, back to your side, and Scott Bryan, you're on the Delmar side. We're ready. They move into the staging phase. Turn.
Too quick off the starting line, and that'll be all in road for the first round of competition for young Scott Bryan. But dejection in the crew as they head back to the truck. What a bummer for Scott Bryan.
The oldest independent drag racing championship in the United States, the famed Bakersfield March Meet in Bakersfield, California. Once a year, the Kern County Racing Association likes to welcome all you fans out here to Pomoso Drag Strip. This drag strip is resounded to the great names of drag racing. Don Carlin, Chris the Greek Caravacini, Don Rudolph, the Blueback. They've all been here, and they're all here today for this March meet in Bakersfield, California. In Pro Cup eliminations, we're underway. The new driver, Scott Bryan. Way in the left-hand lane is competition, the veteran, Jerry Darien, lining up with the bleach box in the right-hand lane. Scott Bryan, of course, you know, just made his driving debut a week ago, and unfortunately was the victim of a red light. But the car with tremendous potential, crew chief John Zedzeas, the Bishop of Fuel Racing Engines.
Winning car here. Ought to sweep the field, you said.
Have a little patience, Mr. Bryan. It takes time for a new car and driver to get together. Scott's got a lot of potential, and he's going to be okay. Just give it a little time.
Yeah, well, at $250 a run, pretty hard to be patient.
Stay cool. Keep the pressure up. Scott's going to be okay. And you start winning your share races.
I'm going down to the starting line and watch for a while.
Yeah, it might be a good idea. Maybe you can learn something.
Your attention to the pits, Scott Bryan. Scott Bryan, please bring your car to the staging lane. Going in for the number 7 qualifier, Paul Phillips, exploding an engine in a qualifying attempt. As the young driver, Scott Bryan, for you fans on hand today, has had a series of tough breaks, mostly of his own making, as a pair of red lights that kept him out of any chance in the winner's circle for quite some time. He's the first car coming down the bush road, Scott Bryan. Should back out of it, but
And there goes the engine. A tough break for Scott Bryan. As the engine exploding right in the finish line, trap Scott Bryan will be coasting to a stop. Oil all over the racetrack. The emergency crew out to clean it up. Scott Bryan has two red lights and now an exploded engine. A tough way to begin a drag racing career for young Scott Bryan. The emergency crew now out on the track. Race sweep going down. As you are aware, it's impossible to run on an oily racetrack. And Scott Bryan definitely left an oily racetrack with a competitor right behind him in that left-hand lane. So the emergency crew will be taking some time out there. It may be a good time for you to drop by the concession stand.
Trying to tell you all these months, you're not listening to the darn word I'm saying. You gotta pay attention.
Look, John, why don't you just get off my case?
You're nothing but a spoiled brat.
Hey, Scott, wait for me.
Hey, here's to Jeff and Scott. One of these years, they'll win one, too.
Can we get out of here? I have a date tonight.
Be talking to Jeff.
Okay, Jeff.
Wasn't our best day, was it?
No.
What's the problem, son?
The problem is either you or me, Dad.
Well, what the hell is that supposed to mean?
It means that I can't make it with you anymore. Look, I want to win as much as you do, but I can't do it with you on my back all the time.
I'm not on your back all the time.
Well, it feels like you are.
What do you propose we do about it?
I don't know. I don't know. All I know is I can't take it anymore. I want out.
You want out? This whole damn thing was your idea. I've got $40,000 tied up in that rig, and I'm out of crew.
So, it's the money.
Oh, shit. Forget it.
I'm sorry, Dad.
You're sorry? You wanted to get into drag racing, so I got you into drag racing. With the best equipment money can buy. And now you haven't got the guts to see it through.
Oh, bullshit! I'm the one that's driving that flying time bomb out there, and you're ordering your lackeys around and worrying about money.
It's not true, Scott.
Look, Dad, drag racing is my thing. It's not yours, and it never was. Now, I guess I just have to do it on my own without you. That's just the way it has to be.
All right.
Look, kid, you can't expect me to do that. I just built your old man a $40,000 rig.
Look, Daryl, there's no hassle with my father.
If there's any argument, it's not with you, it's with me. I don't know who else to ask. I want a chance, Darrell. I just want to learn how to drive.
Look, I've got to drive. Vault Roads is the best there is. We're a team.
I know that, but that's not the point. Look, there's more to it than just getting into that car and driving. Now, Walt worked his way up from the bottom, just like John did, and that's what I want to do. I want a chance. I want to drive.
You want to be a bird dog? You want to be up to your knees in grease? You're already a driver. You want to be a tire wiper?
Yeah.
Look, we don't have any money to pay our crew. They're all volunteer.
I'm not sweating that, Darrell. I have a few bucks stashed away. I want a chance.
Okay, Scott, look. We're leaving for Indianapolis. We'll be gone 6 weeks. We're going to stop by Las Vegas, Seattle, Fremont, and Ontario. It's going to be plenty tough. Think you can handle it?
Yeah. No sweat. Look, Dad, I just came by to tell you I'm leaving. I got a job with Darrell Buell.
What about our car?
Oh, Dad, I'm tired of being Jeff Bryan's son. People don't respect me, and I don't like myself. I can't be an extension of you anymore. I want to be me, and that's what I'm going to do.
I thought Darrell had a driver. What the hell are you going to do for him? Be a gopher?
That's right. If that's what it takes, that's what I'll be. I'll wipe tires rather than drive for you.
All right, Scott. All right. You seem to have made up your mind. I won't stand in your way. But don't come whining back to me when you don't make it. You've had your last chance with me.
Get some sleep, Scott.
That's cool. I'm not tired.
Yeah, man, better get some sleep. Your turn to drive's coming up later on tonight. Anything like this before.
Me too.
Let's see what they have down here.
Funk. Hey, Walt, where are you going, old buddy?
Down to eat.
Come on in. Let's have a little drink of moonshine, okay? Hey, come here. Y'all remember old Walt Rhodes? Richard,
yeah.
Elwes,
how you doing, Walt?
Robert, y'all remember Walt? Bill, you remember Walt here? Sure, we used to race a long time ago. Come on, Walt, let's take a little drink. I mean, I want to see you take a real one. That's good for you. I'm telling you. Is that pretty good stuff?
That's very good
stuff. Very good, huh? That'll get you. I'm telling you.
What have you been doing with yourself?
Oh, I don't know. Just racing every weekend. Just messing around, really. We raced old Paul Candy's last week. You talking about a joke. I mean, tell you, that's a place to go down there at home in Louisiana. That's 50 miles below New Orleans. I didn't even know it existed. Went down there and Paul told us at the race floor, come on and go out on his houseboat. Me and Robert figured that surely he had about a 40-footer, 93 feet long. You couldn't even turn that thing around in the Ohio River. I mean, it was something, I'm telling you.
I always liked
it. Trip. So, plays very hard and races very hard.
From Radcliffe, Kentucky, the old Kentucky moonshiner himself, Dale Funk in the wheel of the Franks and Funk Top Fuel Dragster. Burnout's completed. Dale now approaching the starting line, getting ready for his qualifying attempt. And there he did it, 5.97 seconds for Dale Funk, his speed 242 miles an hour.
Hey, Darrell, how's it going?
Hey, not too bad. Got a few things to do, but we'll be right in there.
Hey, what was the deal with the Bryans? Told me it'd be a pretty good job. I left the other team to take it. 2 months later, I'm out in the cold. What goes? Hi, Scott.
Yeah, what's happening?
Much. Just came to see the races. Mike Sutton, Scott Bryan.
Hi, Scott.
Hey, Mike. How you doing?
We good to talk to you for a minute?
Sure.
Getting ready?
What's on your mind, John?
What's Brian kid doing here?
Well, you know, he came by begging for a job. That whole deal with his old man was just a bummer, and I kind of felt sorry for him, and hell, we needed the help.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you guys run good.
Hey, thanks, babe.
Top Fuel Dragster qualifying will be underway here in just a few moments. If you're back in the pits with a Top Fuel car, gentlemen, and want to make a run in this qualifying session, you've got about 10 minutes to get them to the staging lanes as we will start running the Top Fuel Dragsters for qualifying in just a few moments. It currently takes better than a 6.13 second elapsed time to qualify. That's 6.13 seconds to qualify for this 23rd annual U.S. National. 1,100 race cars, over 70 Top Fuel Dragsters alone, attempting to qualify in this 32-car field that goes off on Monday, Labor Day, here at Indianapolis Raceway Park. The next car down the push road, the Buell Sereno and Rhodes Top Fuel Dragster from California. Walt Rhodes at the wheel of this Rhodes Top Fuel Dragster.
Think it'll hold together?
I hope so. We need another tenth at least.
Where are you gonna get another tenth?
I've got no choice. I've got to put this sucker on kill. Besides, we brought the other engine. Well, I don't know. What do you think, Nick?
Look, whatever it takes, we're here to race.
Qualifying attempt, Shirley Baldowski. Number
Shirley getting there first. Her time, a 6.21 second elapsed time, and a tough break for Walt Rhodes. Not quick enough, and he does not make the 32-car field at the U.S. National.
Slower down. Okay, Walt, that's it. It's got her.
Okay.
I'm the jinx on this team.
It's not your fault. These things just happen.
Well, I think things will get better in Vegas.
I sure hope you're right, Scott.
Then we better go back to the motel. We have to race tomorrow.
I thought we were gonna live it up tonight. Should we have another drink for the man over here?
Gee, you guys sure look happy tonight. Hit the jackpot?
You're looking at the fastest driver in Vegas. 242 miles an hour today.
I like fast men, too.
I think I'm going to take a look after this drink.
Maybe I ought to go, too.
I think you should stick around. You're about to hit that jackpot.
Being late?
No. Just had dinner and a couple of drinks. When I left early, everything was okay. He's feeling pretty good.
Shit.
Attention, please. There are 4 minutes.
Hey, Nick.
Yeah.
Hey, look, man. I can't find a driver anywhere.
Oh.
Hey, this might sound crazy, but what do you say we give the kid a shot at it? Hey, you look pretty good in testing.
Scott, you got your fire suit with you?
You know I have it with me. Why?
Hey, don't get bent out of shape. Nick's just pissed because Walt's not here. Scott, Walt's not here in 10 minutes. We want you to drive the car.
Yeah, you serious?
Let's get it warmed up and get it in line. Go! Have you seen Walt?
No.
What's the deal with Scott driving the car?
Well, Walt didn't show up. Couldn't find a driver.
Why the kid? I always wanted to drive for you. Why didn't you call me?
Look, John, I didn't know where you were. I didn't have time to go around chasing your ass.
Well, let me tell you something. I got a ride, and you can bet your ass you're going to be chasing me all the way through those lights.
Man, I hope Walt's at the motel. All I can see is him lying dead someplace.
Well, if he isn't dead, he'll wish he was by the time I get my hands on him. By the way, Scott, you drove a fine race today. Getting to the final round is not too bad for the first time out.
Oh, will you look at this? What happened?
This better be good or it's your butt.
Well, I met this cocktail waitress. Remember, Scott? Okay, I hung around till she got off work. We went to her place. I guess I had too much to drink. We're getting pretty comfortable, and things were looking pretty good, and about that time, she jumped up and grabbed me and pushed me into the closet. She says, keep quiet. I think my old man's coming. Anyhow, I started to get up off the floor, and I looked up, and there was this 7-foot giant standing over me. This dude picks me up and lays one on me.
All I seen was stars. I don't hardly remember anything after that. What happened out at the races, anyhow?
If you would have been out there, you wouldn't have had to ask.
Hey, I ain't buying that story. Let's go get something to eat.
I think it'd be a real kick. First time I drove a dragster, I got down at the other end, was just couldn't breathe, and I forgot to breathe.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, you haven't been doing bad, huh?
You know, my points here and there.
I'd like to get some of that overseas stuff.
Yeah, that's a kick. Really, that's a kick.
Those people really enjoy you over there.
Yeah,
Yeah, you had a really big crowd in Japan, didn't it?
Yeah, 150,000 people.
Is that right?
It's kind of slick.
That is incredible.
That's a lot of people.
That's, you know, that would be just a thrill. They're all there to see you.
Yeah, lucked out again.
You running those front engine cars?
Oh, yeah. Marvin and I kind of cut our teeth on those front engine cars.
Yeah, I think they should, for a new driver that's never driven a front motor car, somebody should stand in the lights and throw a bucket of hot oil on it.
Yeah, on fire.
Next qualifying attempt, you've got to run hard on this one. It takes better than a 20 to get into the program at present time. Moving on to the third round for the nation, it's going to be Big Ten.
219 miles an hour. The two drivers tied for the points here at this Division 7 Winston World Championship Series race. Sean Cedea and young Scott Bryan.
I'll be back for the race.
Hey, Walt, thanks a lot.
Two more top fuel dragsters into the leak box. The action here trending as we have two drivers tied for the division lead in top fuel eliminator. Sean Cedea, your low qualifier at 5.89 seconds. Scott Bryan, the young driver, just moving into top fuel this year at 5.91. Bryan is top speed of the main at 242 miles an hour.
Hi, John.
Hi, John. Hey, we broke a pump drive on that last pass. I figure you guys probably be the only one here that might have one we can borrow. How about it? Yeah, I suppose so. Why don't you check the trailer?
Yeah, come on.
Hey, Scott.
What, are we going to help him beat us?
Hey, let me straighten you out on something. I want to win this race just as much as you do, but we're not going to back into it. John needs our help. Was the other way around, they'd help us. But that's the way it goes around here, so you better get used to it.
Yeah, you're right. That was a stupid thing for me to say.
Yeah, well, forget it.
The final of Funny Car Eliminator in this Winston World Championship Series race. It is the place Mustang taking home the win. Top Fuel Eliminator, we're ready for you. The finals here at the Division 7 final Winston Series race. We're down to two cars. An entire season of drag racing has gone by the boards. And right now, the final race, the final event of the year, will decide the Winston champion in Division 7. Youngster Scott Bryant driving the Fuel Sereno and Rhodes Top Fuel Dragster. His competition, the KG Pro John Zendejas, at the wheel of the panic car. An interesting sideline. I was back in the pits just a moment ago, and John Zendejas would not even be on the racetrack tonight if it weren't for the sportsmanship of Vic Sereno, Darrell Fuel, Walt Rhodes, and of course Scott Bryant.
Man, it's great.
Yeah, well, from now on, I'll be driving the car, and I won't be going drinking with you anymore.
Oh, look, Walt, I never meant for anything...
I know, it happened, but it won't happen again. Anyhow, we ran a good race.
Congratulations, John.
Thanks.
I hope
so.
Congratulations,
thanks,
John.
Thanks, Nick. How about that?
Is this what you wanted, Scott?
Yeah.
What are you going to do with the puppy, Scott?
Well, I know this nice little old lady who could really use one of these.
Stranger, treat me like a friend. Treat me any way you please, I'll be there in the end. Treat me like a stranger, treat me like a friend. Treat me any way you please, I'll be there in the end. You everything you do. Every other face I see reminds me of you. Treat me like a stranger, treat me like a friend. Treat me any way you please, I'll be there in the end. Stranger, treat me like a friend. Treat me any way you please, I'll be there in the end. Treat me like a stranger, treat me like a friend. Treat me any way you please, I'll be there in the end.